So, namaste everyone. Once again, let us go to the next question, that is on hypocycloid. Fine. So, the hypocycloid question is a bit like this. And now, when we are talking about hypocycloid, as I explained in the previous class, hypocycloid is a curve. You can see that in the blue for the circle which is rolling inside another circle, and the point on this rolling circle. It will travel on a path which we called as the hypocycloid. Fine. Now the formula for theta will remain the same because here also the length of the circle, which is the circumference, has to be equal to the length of the arc. Fine. So the same derivation will go ahead and the final formula remains the same. That is small r, that is the radius of small circle, divided by capital R, which is the radius of the base circle. Into 360 degrees. So we have to use the same formula, find the angle, and similar procedure, not exactly the same, but similar procedure we have to apply here to get the path which is called as the hypocycloid. Fine. So let me take this statement. Once again, I will take the template file. I'll take the template file and I'll keep this question here. Just keep it above so that it doesn't disturb with our drawing. Fine. So this here is the statement. So let us keep it aside and first calculate the radius. Ready? So once again, for hypocycloid as well, we will need the three values, that is small r, capital R, and using these we will calculate the theta. So read the question and tell me what is this value of small r. He is telling the circle of diameter 80 mm is rolling without slipping. So the rolling circle diameter, once again diameter has been given just to confuse you. Fine. So we should not use the diameter as it is, we need the radius, that is half of diameter. So 80 by 2 we get 40. So the small r value is 40 here. And then he is telling inside a circular path of radius 160 mm. So here radius has been given directly. Fine. Here he is not trying to confuse us. So radius is given directly. So that is 160. Now once again we have to use the formula for theta. So that is small r by capital R into 360. So that these values, let us feed it. So 40 divided by 160 into 360. So once again simplify this, we get 4 ones are 4 fours are, and we get 90 degrees. Fine. So this is the angle which we have to draw. So let us proceed, magnify this, go a little below. Once again I have to start with a line, and again I can draw the starting line wherever I want. I can draw the starting line wherever I want, but just to make it look good, let me just calculate the angle on both the sides. Fine. So once again here, if I want it to be exactly balanced, this angle here is 90. I have to calculate these two angles. Fine. So what is the formula for calculating that? 180 minus 90 by 2. Fine. So that's the formula to get these angles. So what do we get here? 180 minus 90 is again 90, and 90 by 2 is 45. So 45 degrees we have to take the line. So in the polar setting, keep the polar setting on and choose 45 degrees from here. Then click on the line, yell enter, click at a point, and on the left side you can see the angle we have to take is 135. Angle we have to take is 135. Draw a large enough line. Fine. We can trim it if we don't need later. So draw a large line. Now what is the first circle that we have to draw? We have to first draw the path circle. So the radius of the path circle, he is telling it is 160 mm. So let us take circle, C enter, click on the endpoint. Radius we have to feed 160, enter. And you can see this is the path. Next I will take another circle, and now I have to draw the rolling circle. Fine. Now I don't know the center point where it should be, So what I'll do, I'll just draw the circle with the midpoint of the line. So somewhere I have to draw it. Somewhere on this line I have to draw the circle. And the radius of that circle, we have seen it here, radius of that circle is 40 mm. So let us feed 40, enter. You can see the circle is not touching our path. That's because we have randomly chosen some point on the line. So now select the circle, take move command from here, or just press M, enter. Pick this from the intersection point of the line and rolling circle and move this to this point. Now we can see our circle, rolling circle, is touching the path. Now I can give the trim command, TR, double enter, click on this to remove it. Now I'll have to get the angle. So what is the angle? The angle is 90 degrees. So I have to select the line, RO, enter, select the end point and right click, select copy. If you don't select copy, that line itself will move. And then angle we have to feed minus 90 degrees. So you can see a copy of this line has been rotated by 90 degrees. Now select both these lines, press TR, enter, and click on the circle, the part of the circle which we don't need. So this here is this diagram which you should get. After this, we have to get the center arc. To get the center arc, we will be using O, enter, right click, choose through, select this arc, click on the center of the circle. So you have to get the center of the circle, we have to once touch this circle, only then it will be displayed. Fine, click on that. So we can see that we got the center arc. Now this path we have to divide into number of equal parts. How many number of parts? You can take 12 or you can take 8, it's up to you. So let us go ahead and take 12 parts. So divide command, div, enter, select the center arc, press 12, enter. You can see the points are directly visible because we changed the value of P type when we were drawing epicycloid. Next, we have to name the center points. So I'll just copy this, copy paste this at all the points. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So this is 12, this is 3, this is 6, sorry. So only the important points I have marked here. In the in between points, you know what they are, right? Next, we have to divide the circle also into 12 parts. Once again, we have to take the starting line here. So I'll take a line, another line, starting from center point till it touches the intersection point. Fine. So for epicycloid, we had taken the line below. For this one, we have to take the line above. 10:30. Then we have to take a copy of this, make 12 copies around. So select the line, press AR, enter, choose polar option, click on the center of rolling circle. By default it will create 6 copies, but we want 12. So go up here and press 12, enter. You can see we got the 12 divisions here. We can name the points. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sorry. 1, 2, 3 will be here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we can change these names. Fine, because the space is less, I'm not naming all the points, I'm just naming important points at a gap of 3, 3. Next, let me change this circle also to red to avoid confusion. You need not change the this. So this I'm just doing so that you can clearly make out the difference. Okay. So till here it's clear. Next we have to take offset of this passing through all these points. So take O, enter, right click and choose through option, click on the arc, click on the point, click on the arc, point, arc, this end point, fine, be careful, this, again this point, again go ahead, again go ahead. So you have to take the last one single point as well, fine, don't forget to take that. Then select the circle, press EX, enter, then click on all the arcs so that the arcs expand to the previous points also. Now you can see that each arc is passing through two points, one this and the other here, fine. So that has to be done accordingly, and that is the reason why we took the starting line here. If you don't take the starting line here, then the arcs will not match both the end points. Okay, now that we have taken everything, we just have to start marking the points. So take the circle, pick it from the center, keep it at the center point C1 and mark the intersection point. So intersection point, okay, there was one mistake I made here. Actually the point starts here at the top, not at the bottom. The point doesn't start here, the point starts here at the top. So we have to start numbering it in clockwise direction. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3. 3 comes here. 3 comes here. Then 6 comes here. Then 9 comes here. And last point is 12. That is here. Fine. So the intersection of the circle and path in hypercycloid is at the top. So you have to start from the top in clockwise direction. Fine. So when you move this circle to the next point, you have to take the intersection of first arc with the first circle. Okay, so this is the intersection point we have to take. So be very, very careful. These points are very, very near to each other. You may end up selecting some other point. You should not do that. Fine. So we have to select intersection of the path circle and this arc. So PO, enter, select here. Next, keep on moving this to the next center and mark the point. Move it, mark it. Here again you can see the points are very near. You have to mark the intersection of these two, not the line. Fine. Be careful slightly when you do that. Then the next one. So now when you come to the next one, after this arc, after this arc, it may you may assume this to be the next arc. Fine, please don't assume this. This is just for the center. That's why I have marked it red also. Okay. So after this one, we have to mark this arc next. Fine. Don't mark the intersection of these two. No. You have to mark the intersection of this arc and this after this. Okay. So take point, intersection. Go ahead. This is C4. So we have to take the fourth one here, C6, that is the bottommost, then 7. Now till half we can see we have chosen the left side points. Now after the half, after C6, we have to choose the right side parts. Fine. So the point should be on the right side, not on the left side. So go ahead, do the same. So after moving, I am giving the point command. After moving, I am giving the point command and I am placing the point. Fine. So once again, the last, you can see this is very, very near to each other. Be careful that you mark the intersection of the circle and arc, not the line. Fine. And the last one, once again, it will touch the path circle. Last one will touch the path circle. Fine. So by mistake, if you have marked the intersection of the center arc and the circle, what will happen is the last point will not come here. The last point will end here itself, fine, because two points we would have taken on the circle. So that's how you can identify the mistake and rectify it later at least. Fine. So since now we have all the points, we can also name all these points. Once again, I'll just name the important points. So okay, it starts here. P1, P2, P3. So this one is P3. P4, P5, P6. 6 is here. 7, 8, 9 is here. And 10, 11, 12, the last point. So I've named all the points. Now I have to join all these using a smooth line. So SPL, enter. Start here once again at the intersection point. Fine. Many students forget this last point. They start here. Fine. So you have to consider this first point as well. Then keep on joining all these points. So P3, P4, P5, P6, P7, P8, P9, P10, P11, P12. Sorry. Okay. So this path that you got, this is a hypocycloid, right? And once again, if you want to be if you want it to be exact, you have to keep here, choose the tangent option, and the tangent has to be this line, fine. But this time we cannot take the click on the line at the bottom, fine. So we have to take the point at the top, fine. So if you keep your cursor here for some time and then extend, you can see it is showing the tangent option. When you choose that tangent option, so the same you have to repeat right side. Fine. So this will ensure it is exactly as we want it. Once everything is done, then you can just use these to apply the properties. Fine. So all the construction lines, they have to be like this, fine. If the properties are not getting applied on the array, explode it, and then you can apply this. So construction lines, so all these are construction lines. Then whenever you are using dimensions, if you are showing the angle, for example, if you are showing, match the properties with dimension text. Solid lines should be matched with the main arc, fine. And the dimension, you just make the circle, and the path, this is the bottom circle is the path here. So the circle and the bottom circle, you have to make it dark here, whereas in hypocycloid, the top arc and the circle, you have to make it like that. Coming to the solid, you have to make this arc as solid. We just have 10 minutes to end this class. And we are yet to learn about the tangents and normals. Fine. You can see here that the problem ends with the last point, that is tangent and the normal. So let us see how to draw the tangent and normal for both of these. So in this case, where does he want the tangent and normal? He wants it at a point S, which is 40 mm above the circular path. 40 mm above the circular path. So circular path is here. So from the circular path, we need at 40 mm. So I have to give the command O, enter, 40, enter, select the path, click above the path. Now the intersection of the curve and the arc, this is the point, yes. That is the point, yes. So I can just copy the text, change it to yes, capital S. Okay. So that is where we want our tangent and normal. So to draw the tangent and normal, we have to use this circle once again. Keep the center point at the point S. Then you have to get a point on the center arc. You have to get a point on the center arc. And this you have to join with the main center. So when you do that, you will get the intersection of this line with the path, So this point, we have to join it with the point S. That point we have to join with the point S. So this line that we got here, this is the normal. This line is the normal. So normal we will always name it as m n. We will always name it as m n. And then we need a tangent. To get tangent, we have to rotate a copy of this by 90 degrees. So select the line, arrow enter, select this point, right click, choose copy, and fade 90 degrees from the keyboard. So this here is the tangent, and this here is the normal. So you can just make it as T. So ST is the tangent and MN is the normal. So I can again choose MA enter for match properties. Solid lines, we have to make it for tangent and normal, because tangent and normal are very, very important. And construction lines should be applied on this. If you want, you can show the dimensions also. Take aligned dimension from top here, from the path to this point. You can see this length is 40 mm. You can also show the radii if you want. So radius of this is 90. Take this circle, keep it back, and choose the diameter for this. You can say it's 60. Once again, match the properties of the dimensions to all these dimensions. Fine. Now let us draw tangent and normal to the hypocycloid. Let's go back to the question. Where do we need the tangent and normal? We need again at a point S. Now this, in this case, the point S is 52 mm from the circular path. So once again, I have to press O enter, 52 enter. Now where is the path? The path is not the bottom arc here, it is the top arc. So you have to click on the top arc and click below it. So you can see again it is intersecting at two points. One is at the left, the second is at the right. So let us avoid taking the left part, because already there are a lot of drawing objects here. Let us take the right part. Fine. So I will take a point here at this. Now at this point, we have to draw tangent and normal. So once again, we have to take this circle from the center point. Keep the center point where you want the normal. Using that, get a point on the center arc. Get a point on the center arc. Fine. So all these points, I'll just make them different in color. Let me make them green. Fine. So this is what we took it. Next, what you should do, we have to join this point, the point S, with the bottom. Now we need the intersection of this line with the path, fine, not the bottom arc. We need the top arc, because in the hypocycloid, the top arc is the path. So select the top arc, EX enter, and click on the line. So this point we get, fine. So let us move this circle back to its place. Take L enter. From this point, join it to the, from this point, we have to take a line to the point S. Where is the point S? It's here, fine. So this line here is the normal. This line here is the normal. Once again, we have to rotate a copy of that by 90 degrees. So select the line, arrow enter, select the point, right click, copy, and 90 degrees. So you can see we got the tangent. Fine. Once again, match properties. Solid should be applied. Solid should be applied on normal and tangent. You can also name this. Normal should be named as M N. This point here is S, capital S, and another point, either left side or right side, we can name it as T. So ST is the tangent, MN is the normal. Once again, we can apply the properties to all these. Once again, the lines, you can see properties are not changing. Select all these lines, press X enter to explode it. You can see the lines are now different. Now match properties, choose construction and apply the same for all these lines. So this arc also is just a construction arc, so you can apply construction properties to that also. And finally again we can show the dimensions. This one we are showing from the top to this point, you can say it's 52, and of course the diameter of the ruling circle, which is 80, and radius for the path circle. Be careful, you have to choose the upper radius, not the lower one. Once again, match the properties of the dimensions to all these dimensions. Fine. Finally, I'll just put the angle as well here. So that's it. Any doubts here? So if you have any doubts while watching the video, you can just put it in the comments, and in the next class we will take up the next topic. Fine. So assignment to the cycloids also will be available on the Teams starting today, tonight. By next week you should be able to complete this as well. Thank you.